Pharrell was in a group with Timberland and Magoo called SBI, which stood for Surrounded by Idiots.
SBI, wow. SBI is a group that Timberland had that I was in along with Magoo called Surrounded by Idiots.
Gucci Mane, well, he played James Franco's drug dealer in the film Spring Breakers, but the guy fell asleep during his sex scene. De La Soul's Stakes Is High album marked the first time the group was able to come up with the album title before creating the music. According to Rolling Stone magazine, A$AP Rocky, he has the diamond and topaz ring that once belonged to the King of Dubai. It was a gift to him from Swizz Beatz. The day Frank Ocean came out as bisexual, he also attended John Legend's 4th of July barbecue. Now, I just did it Before They Are Famous on Frank Ocean here on my personal channel. I've actually done a Before They Are Famous on a lot of these artists, so be sure to browse around, pick one out, hit subscribe, all that good stuff. My name is Michael McCracken. Welcome to part 4 of 25 random hip-hop facts. I got a whole bunch of good ones, so let's get back to this list. Trick Daddy, he suffers from discoid lupus, but he refuses to take any medication for it. Wyclef Jean, he once had a song with Dwayne The Rock Johnson titled, It Doesn't Matter. Cause if you ain't sharing, people ain't caring. We gotta roll another clip. Yo, Rock, I just bought a fresh Bentley. It doesn't matter if you just bought a fresh Bentley. According to his Twitter, Warren G would like to teach a hip-hop class at CSULB, USC, or UCLA. Master P was the first rapper of all time to make $100 million and to own all of his masters. Although at the time of this recording, the guy is going through one messy divorce. I'm assuming that wife, she's asking for a few of them masters. So then he'd be like, former Master P, right? Kobe Bryant, he had a cameo in Destiny's Child music video, Bugaboo. In fact, those two other girls that were in Destiny's Child, well, that was a bit of a cameo for themselves. Like, where did they go? ODB co-produced the Wu-Tang Clan's The Mystery of Chess Boxing. J. Cole produced Kendrick Lamar's High Power and marked their first collaboration together. Kendrick had this to say. His production is crazy, man. The first time we locked in, he played about 10 beats. I wanted 11 of them. The reason Diddy changed his name from Puff Daddy was to start new. He told Oprah, during the Puff Daddy era, I got into a lot of trouble. In 1999, he was charged with weapons possession and bribery after shooting at a New York City nightclub and faced up to 15 years in prison. He was tried and acquitted in 2001. He continued, after the trial, I just said, I'm changing my name. Missy Elliott had a song with Mel B of the Spice Girls. It was titled, I Want You Back. Let's roll a clip. I'm the M to the ELB, you know me. I'm the M-I-S-S-Y to the Dido, who appeared in Eminem's track Stan, well, she actually went on to name her child Stan. She stated, he could have never been called anything else. To be honest, I'm so stupid. I didn't think anyone would make the connection. She continued, it's fine. By the way, I'm named after some crazy queen who threw herself on top of a fire. T.I., you can find him in the movie Identity Thief. Talib Kweli studied experimental theater at New York University. Both his parents were professors. Scott Storch, well, he's the man who played the keyboards on Dr. Dre's Still Dre. Love that. Lefty Lopez, her second solo album, N.I.N.A., was supposed to feature several songs with Ray J. She was signed to Suge Knight's revamp of Death Row, simply known as The Row. Unfortunately, with Left Eye, she would pass away before this album came out, and Ray J, well, he went on to have a sex tape career with Kim Kardashian. Before Pamela Anderson would star in Kanye West's Touch the Sky, she also appeared in Jay-Z's Hey Poppy. Even if they don't understand the flow, they understand the dough. At the age of 17, Big Sean's brand new Impala was stolen after he left it in his driveway with the keys in the ignition. A tracking device had been installed in the car and was later recovered, although it was slightly damaged and the thing was missing a wheel. Yeah, not a good break. When Rihanna's not recording music, touring, or hanging out with her boobs out, well, she likes a good old night of karaoke in Koreatown. Her favorite songs to sing are Bon Jovi's Living on a Prayer and Early No Doubt. Before Daughters, Nas wrote another song about his daughter, Destiny, called Me and You, dedicated to Destiny.
I like to dedicate this one here to my star, someone I cherish. She loves me unconditionally, no matter what.
One of Wiz Khalifa's favorite restaurants is P.F. Chang's. He also likes Capital Grill, Chicken and Lobster. Finally, in the number 25 spot, Dr. Dre, he wasn't a fan of 50 Cent's 21 Questions on Get Rich or Die Tryin'. In fact, he wanted it nowhere on the album. He's like, dude, I love you more than a fat kid loves cake. That ain't gangster. Hey guys, that's all I got for you in this video. Be sure to let me know if you want to see another 25 random hip-hop facts in the future. Also, be sure to browse this channel. I've done bios on most of these artists we spoke about. And let me know who you want to hear more facts about in the future. Okay, my name is Michael Crud. See you guys in the next one. Boom!